Welcome back to Unbox Paradigm, and this here is the Gigabyte G5 M. I've been using the Gigabyte G5 for about 2 weeks now, and here are my full thoughts on it. Gigabyte is a relatively new brand when it comes to laptops in the Indian market. However, they have been making graphics cards, motherboards, and monitors for quite a while now, and they are well known among the tech community as well as PC builders. This laptop right here is the Gigabyte G5 M, which is a mid-range gaming laptop that falls in the under Rs. 75,000 pricing segment. Here are its specifications. At a starting price of just Rs. 66,000, the Gigabyte G5 MF offers an RTX 4050 6GB graphics card. At its price segment, this is one of the only few gaming laptops to offer an RTX 4050 6GB graphics card. While this model that I have reviewed has an i5 12th gen 12500H 12 core processor, this is also available at a higher variant, which has an i7-12650H. The i7 variant is currently available at just Rs. 71,000. For a gaming laptop that has an i7 12th gen processor as well as an RTX 4050 6GB graphics card, this is one of the only few laptops that you are likely to find at this price. Now, if you would like to check out the i7 variant which I just mentioned, I'll be leaving the product links in the video description. Right out of the box, the laptop has a minimal design with a bold Gigabyte logo in the front and a subtle decal in the corner suggesting that this is no business laptop, although it does look like one. So for those of you who are trying to get a gaming laptop or simply a high-end laptop which you would like to take into your university or your professional environments, this is one gaming laptop which you can consider. This does not stand out as how other gaming laptops do, and it also has all the benefits of a gaming laptop. There are four exhaust fans around the laptop, one on either sides and two in the rear. Similarly, there's an extensive port selection here around the sides and the rear. Just like most other gaming laptops, the Gigabyte G5 also has its intake vents right below the laptop. So ideally, you should not be using it on your lap or your bed, as this can block the intake, which would limit the airflow required to cool down the laptop. There are 12 screws at the bottom of the device, which you will need to remove to access the internal RAM and SSD slots. The laptop feels very rigid and is well built, which is very welcome to see on a mid-range gaming laptop. The hinges are sturdy and the display does not wobble while typing or gaming. Single-handed opening is a little tricky to get it right. However, once you get used to it, you just need to open the lid at the right speed with the right force to get it right. The keyboard deck also feels very solid and does not seem to have any keyboard flicks. I like how clean and minimal the keyboard layout is. This is a full-size keyboard with full-size number pad, and unlike some laptops, the arrow keys have not been shrunk either. The power button is also completely away from the keyboard on the top right corner, so you don't have to worry about accidentally turning off or putting your laptop to sleep. I also like that this keyboard layout has a right-click key right beside the control button, which I find convenient. However, one issue that I have with this layout is that the 0 key on the number pad is not below the number 1 as seen on the standard layouts. So oftentimes when I have to enter 0, I instead end up accidentally pressing the right key. But I think this may not be a major issue once you get used to this keyboard. The keyboard here also has a single zone RGB function. The keyboard, as mentioned before, is full size and has a single zone RGB. This means that you don't get to assign different colors for different zones on the keyboard, and instead all colors will be moving at the exact same time, since it's a single zone RGB keyboard. Note that you get 15 predefined different colors and cannot set the lights to a custom color of your choice. But this is still better than having just a single backlight option, which is found in some of the competing laptops at this price point. The trackpad is nothing much to speak of. It is a standard trackpad that's fairly big and works as expected. This is how the G5 looks like on the inside. Firstly, it gets dual M.2 SSD slots. This is again very welcome and something very simple which you would think every manufacturer would include. But there are still higher end laptops which cost a lot more and still ship with a single SSD slot. However, do note that out of the two SSD slots which are present on the Gigabyte G5, one of the SSD slots supports Gen 4 while the other supports Gen 3. Now, while Gen 4 SSDs are faster than Gen 3 SSDs, for the majority of use cases, there is not going to be any significant difference in real life performance. And here is your Wi-Fi M.2 card. Gigabyte has gone with the Intel AX211, which supports up to Wi-Fi 6E and Bluetooth 5.3. The G5 also gets dual DDR4 RAM slots, and these support up to 64GB RAM and up to 3200MHz frequency. Most laptops, while supporting up to 64GB of RAM in their DDR4 or DDR5 RAM slots, the official specifications are often limited up to 32GB of RAM. This is just the official specification which they have tested and does not necessarily mean that your device is limited only up to 32GB of RAM. To find out the maximum RAM capacity that your laptop can handle, you can go to websites like Crucial or Kingston to find the maximum compatible memory for your laptop. As mentioned before, I like the port selection here. There are many ports here and these are placed functionally around the sides as well as the rear of the laptop. On the right, you get a microSD card reader, a single USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-C port and an Ethernet RJ45 port. Now on the rear, you get the DC adapter port or your power port, a mini display port 1.4, an HDMI 2.1 out and another USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-C port. I like how these specific ports such as the video out ports or your power adapter ports are present on the rear side of the laptop since these are the cables which you are most likely to keep connected for a longer duration. And this way you get to have both the sides of your laptop both clutter and cable free. Now coming to the display, the G5 uses an InnoLux panel. This is a 15.6-inch FHD panel with a 144Hz refresh rate. It also gets 250 nits of brightness, but the color space is limited to 45% NTSC. This might not be much of an issue for users who are just casually using it for gaming or any other work usage. However, for video editors or content creators, it is recommended that you use an external display with a 100% sRGB color gamut. Or you could look into other laptops which offer a 100% sRGB display. For a budget gaming laptop, this is a pretty decent display, and the lack of 100% sRGB isn't as bad as you might think. Additionally, you can also tune your display using the built-in Intel color management and Windows color management to make the display more vibrant. This turns performance in day-to-day usage runs great. The Windows 11 Home boots up in about 15 seconds from a completely turned-off state. The G5 also uses Gigabyte's own SSDs, and this is how it performs in Crystal Disk benchmark. At over 4,500 megabytes per second, the sequential read speeds are fairly high, while the sequential write speeds are more along the lines of a Gen 3 SSD at slightly over 2,000 megabytes per second. But don't get me wrong, while this is not the fastest Gen 4 SSD that you can get in the market right now, it is still plenty fast for majority of the applications and games, as well as for file transfers. Now coming to the different performance modes available in the Gigabyte Control Center, you get the performance mode, entertainment mode, power saving mode, and then you get the quiet mode. You also get to choose between auto, max, and custom fan speeds where you can set your own custom fan curve. During my period of testing, I did not find any significant advantage by choosing for a custom fan curve. So I would suggest that you can just leave the fan settings to its default auto mode. Now let's check out the performance in different modes. Even though this G5 is a 2023 laptop, it still uses an i5 12th gen processor. Now while the i5 12th generation is technically 2 generations old than the current ongoing 14th generation processors, there has not been a significant advancement since the 12th generation. So as long as Gigabyte is able to provide acceptable levels of CPU performance, while at the same time reducing the cost of the laptop by opting for an older generation processor, I think this is a win-win for both the consumers as well as for the brand. As you will now see in the benchmarks, the i5 12th generation processor available on this Gigabyte G5 actually comes close to the i5 13th gen processor found in competing laptops such as the Acer Nitro V, which further validates my point that you can go for older generation processors and not necessarily lose any significant amount of performance. Here's how the G5 MF performs in Cinebench 2024 in various modes. In performance mode with auto fans, you get a single core rating of 101 points and multi-core rating of 682 points. With max fan speed, the points are quite close and don't make a lot of difference, so you are better off just leaving the fans at auto settings. In entertainment mode, the single core performance remains the same while the multi-core performance takes a slight hit. So for general use, you will be just fine using the entertainment mode. In power saving mode, the single core performance now takes a hit, but it is still good enough for general usage such as web browsing or streaming. The multi-core performance is now significantly lower since the processor is now running at a much lower power. And finally, in the quiet mode, you get very similar results to the power saving mode, along with similar power consumption. However, while it is not obvious here, the power saving mode also disables your discrete graphics card. Now here's how it performs in Cinebench R23. In performance mode, you get single core scores over 1600 points and multi-core scores over 10,200 points. In this test, there was a slight improvement in performance by leaving the fans at max speed, with the multi-core score now crossing 11,000 points. Note that, outside of benchmarks, these scores don't make a noticeable difference in your general usage. You can pause and check out the performance in other properties. Now comparing the scores from the performance mode against other laptops, the G5 MF matches the single-core performance of the MacBook Pro 14 2023 with the M2 Max chipset, while the multi-core performance is similar to the i5 13th Gen 13420H on the Acer Nitro V. The single-core performance is also only marginally behind the i5 13th Gen found on the Acer Nitro V. For analyzing the graphics performance of this laptop, I have run various synthetic benchmarks as well as gaming benchmarks. Let's check them out. Starting with the synthetic benchmarks, first we have the 3D Mark 5 Strike results. The overall 5 Strike scores are a little over 17,700 points, and the 5 Strike graphics scores are over 20,700 points. This places it above the average of an RTX 4050 6GB graphics card. You can pause and refer the rest of the 3D Mark results. The RTX 4050 on the G5 is over 47% better than RTX 3050 Ti. This is a sign to avoid all RTX 3050 and 3050 Ti laptops if it is possible within your budget to get an RTX 4050 laptop. When it comes down to gaming performance, there is just no competition, and the RTX 4050 absolutely demolishes any RTX 3050 or 50 Ti graphics cards. Now for gaming benchmarks. Here are the benchmarks of control at various graphics settings. I would suggest playing at high preset with ray tracing and DLSS enabled for an optimal experience. When compared against other laptops, the G5 holds up quite well and performs as expected. When DLSS is enabled, this laptop performs better than full-sized RTX 3060 laptops. For a 75W RTX 4050, this graphics card offers very reliable performance, especially for Full HD gaming with good graphics settings as well as good FPS. In Cyberpunk 2077, the G5 is able to achieve close to 60 FPS at high settings without any DLSS and frame gen enabled. This is slightly slower than the Nitro V as seen in the graph, but the Nitro V also costs more as of the time of publishing this video. When DLSS, quality settings, and frame gen is enabled, there is a significant boost in performance that outperforms the native performance of an RTX 4070 Legion Slim 7. This is exactly why in 2024 you should get an RTX 4000 series GPU if it is available within your budget. The DLSS and frame gen capabilities will ensure that your GPU should be able to handle upcoming games at good quality settings in the long run. Note that for the presets draw, the ones without ray tracing utilizes FSR and frame gen, while the ones with RT utilizes DLSS and frame gen. Moving on to the noise levels, the fan speeds of the G5 are somewhere around 6000 RPM at best. This also means that the Gigabyte G5 is a relatively quiet laptop when you compare it to other alternative laptops in the market, such as the Acer Nitro V, which reaches up to 8000 RPM and gets fairly loud. So in a way, while this laptop does run at quiet noise levels, it also means that it is running at a slightly higher temperature than what the Acer Nitro V or something else with a higher fan speed runs at. However, as mentioned before, while the G5 does run slightly on the warmer side, it does not experience any kind of thermal throttling, and hence you won't find any kind of stuttering while gaming. During my period of testing, there was one instance where I could notice some kind of stuttering, but I could no longer reproduce the same issue again. So I think this could have been due to something else, and so hopefully the stuttering was just a one-time issue. Coming to the webcam, the G5 is equipped with a 720p sensor, and you also get a white LED light which sits right beside the webcam, and it activates when your webcam is in use. The audio. The speakers are most noticeably the worst part of this laptop, and as such, I would not recommend the speakers for anything other than just casual usage. If you are looking to watch a music video or watch a movie or listen to your favorite music, I would suggest that you opt for your speakers or in earphones, because the speakers just are not good. They sound super muffled, and I do not wish this upon anybody. That's way too exaggerated. Coming to the battery runtimes, the Gigabyte G5 has an Intel processor, and it also has a relatively small size battery of just 54W. An Intel chipset and a lower battery capacity is not a good combination, especially when it comes to an 8 series processor. This also means that the processor will consume a vast amount of power, and with this power, it does come at a cost of your battery runtimes. And as such, this G5 will last you only up to a maximum of 3 to 4 hours, and that's at power saving mode with low brightness. But then again, most gaming laptops at this price do not tend to last that long. So who is the Gigabyte G5 for, and who should get this? Now for the conclusion, so what do I think about the Gigabyte G5? At a starting price of just ₹66,000, you get an RTX 4050 6GB graphics card based gaming laptop. And this is not something that is very common at this price segment. While there are plenty of RTX 3050 laptops, an RTX 4050 graphics card is about 40 to 60% faster than any RTX 3050 laptops that you can find. So whether you are a gamer or an architect or a designer or a video editor or a content creator who uses DaVinci Resolve, then a good graphics card is what you need to prioritize. And as such, I think the G5 makes for a very excellent choice worth considering at a starting price of ₹66,000. Now, while this variant which I have reviewed here is the 12500H, it costs ₹76,000 for some reason. And at the moment of publishing this video, the i7 variant costs just ₹71,000. But I would recommend that based on the experience that I've had with this i5 variant, I am pretty confident that the i7 will be useful for those of you who need higher multi-core performance. But for those of you who need just the graphics performance of an RTX 4050, the one starting at ₹66,000 with an i5 12450H is also a good choice worth considering, especially since it's around ₹5,000 lower priced. Now, who shouldn't get this? if you are a designer who needs a good display, or if you do not use an external display and color accuracy is something that you require, in such cases, this is not a laptop that you should choose. 100% sRGB color gamut is what you need to look for. And most laptops at this price segment do not offer a 100% sRGB color gamut. If you are a designer, you probably know what I'm talking about. And if not, this may not be something that you need to be worried about. I guess that's it. This is my review of the Gigabyte G5 MF. And I hope you liked the video. If you have any feedback or comments, please let me know in the comment section. Or if you have any kind of thoughts on this laptop, please let me know. And I will try to answer them to the best of my knowledge. If you like this video and if you would like to see more content from me, then please like this video as well as subscribe to the channel. I guess that's it. See you in the next one.